But Jesus said is to take up our cross and follow him daily, a daily cross. Daily we have something or other to suffer. Jesus said, take up your cross and follow me. My comfort is in carrying the cross. I have daily, all of us have daily something or other to suffer. My husband not understanding me, my wife nagging me, my children not caring for me, my people in the office finding fault with me, I getting sick, there's something or other to suffer all the time. But when I go to my God, when I go to my God with all these pains and aches and troubles and problems, it is the Holy Spirit who comforts me. I feel the comfort. I feel the touch, the heavenly touch of Jesus, of the Holy Spirit. Remember, Jesus himself went to Gethsemane because the cross was staring into his eyes. In a few hours' time, he would be betrayed, he would be condemned, he would be laid on the cross, and the nails would be driven in his palms, and he would be hanging on the cross. Jesus saw it all, everything. And he was shattered. He was deeply distressed. And he went to Gethsemane, and he prayed, Father, please, I cannot carry this cross. Let this bitter chalice go away from me. And that's when the Holy Spirit came to console him, to comfort him. It is in the comfort of the Holy Spirit that he was able to say, Father, let your will be done. But brothers and sisters, only when we are comforted by the Holy Spirit, only then we will be able to fulfill our responsibilities of life. I remember a man coming here. He said he had already filed the papers for the divorce. I asked him what happened. He said, Father, I cannot live with that woman, my wife. She always nags me. I come from my office and she does not give me a smile. She's always there to find fault with me. And Father, it's too much, too much. I don't want to bear that burden anymore. Let her go and do what she wants. Whatever money she wants, I'm ready to give her, but I don't want this burden. It's too much. I told him, my friend, I understand you perfectly well. It is so difficult to live with a woman who nags you, who does not understand you, who does not love you. It is so difficult. But I told him, you have a mission to save her. If you abandon her, she will be lost. She will be lost. You have a mission to fulfill by saving her. And he asked me, Father, I'm not able to. Yes, I told him, I understand you. You're not able to. But you will receive the comfort of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit will comfort you. In the comfort of the Holy Spirit, you will be able to feel the heavenly power, the heavenly touch flowing into you. And then you will be able to fulfill your responsibility. Jesus said, wait and pray until you receive the power from above. Holy Spirit is the power of God. The power of God descending into us and filling us. This power of the Holy Spirit is manifested in us in 9 ways. And St. Paul speaks to us about it. Galatians chapter 5. Galatians chapter 5, verses 22 and 23. The 9 ways in which the power of the Holy Spirit is manifested in us. St. Paul calls them the fruit of the Holy Spirit. And the first fruit is love. Love, peace, joy. Patience, kindness, goodness. Self-control, faithfulness and gentleness. These are the manifestations of the power of the Holy Spirit. It's like a ray of light entering through a prism. When a ray of light enters through the prism, what happens? It comes out in seven beautiful flashing colors, right? Same way, when the Holy Spirit enters into our soul, the Holy Spirit is manifested in these nine beautiful powers. And all these nine fruits are powers of the Holy Spirit. Love is a power. Love is more than sentiments and emotions and feelings. Love is a power. That power of love was manifested on the cross. When dying on the cross, being reviled and despised in terrible bodily and mental anguish, betrayed and condemned, there he was lying in the power of the Holy Spirit, in the power of love. He prayed for everyone who did this to him. Father, forgive them. Father, forgive them. They do not know what they are doing. This is power. This is the power of love. It is more than sentiments. It's more than emotions. It's more than feelings. It is a commitment. It is a decision. A decision to love, to respect, to care for the other, care for the one who broke me. That's a power. Commitment to each other.